While there are so many grieving, the bomb squad this morning is on the scene at the gunman's home.
That's where that part of the investigation is unfolding now as they look to find an answer to the question why. Why did this happen? What was the motive? Crime Reporter Sara Stinson gives us an update now from the scene as it's still very active behind you there, Sarah.
James, Daria, as you know, last hour I was reporting right in front of the home, and I got pushed out just moments ago to outside of the court here. It's Angmar Court, because they are heading in, the San Jose Police Bomb Squad. They're heading back inside to investigate and remove explosives from the home. They don't know if they will be, you know, dangerous, so they have to safely remove them and detonate them. That means there's more explosives that they're having to sift through in this home of the gunman, Samuel Cassidy, 57-year-old Samuel Cassidy. Take a look at video I just shot, and thank goodness I got it, because you can see up close where I was. It's the home of Cassidy. He lived there for years and years, and you can see his belongings sitting in the driveway. His neighbors said he was quiet and always alone. FBI and ATF agents have been seen going in and out of here, gathering evidence since day one. As you recall, a fire broke out here at the gunman's home just 3 minutes after the mass shooting at the VTA yard. And so they're still trying to figure out, you know, did he, you know, have an explosive go off after he left? Did he ignite a fire before he left? We just don't know. They're still investigating. We also have video now of the 57-year-old Cassidy leaving his home that day, Wednesday morning, wearing a work uniform early that morning with a large duffel bag. We also know inside that bag was semi-automatic handguns inside with magazines full of ammunition. Those guns appeared to be legal to the sheriff. She says that she's not sure if those were modified, but they are legal. This home caught fire, as I said, 3 minutes after shots rang out at the VTA rail yard, about 8 miles from the home. That's how long it takes, about like 12 minutes to drive from the home to the rail yard. We also have video of him walking on the grounds of the facility. That's new video we can show you this morning. The shots rang out at 6:34 in the morning, and we now have a little more information as to why he would decide to open fire on his coworkers. A Biden administration official confirms that while being detained by U.S. Customs officers back in 2016 for a trip in Philippines, Cassidy had books about terrorism and notes indicating he hated his workplace. And that was in 2016. After interviewing witnesses from the scene, speeding up to 2021, just this last Wednesday, sheriff's officials say Cassidy targeted specific coworkers.
That he said to one of the people there, "I'm not going to shoot you," and then he shot other people. So I imagine there was some kind of thought on who he wanted to shoot. I think it was deliberate, well planned. I think he was moving quickly. It certainly was well planned, because he walked into his business with a duffel bag that had firearms and ammunition.
The FBI and bomb squad have been searching for bombs and explosives here at his home and at the VTA yard as well. So far, San Jose police say they have found explosives and that they continue to find them, and that is why they're here right now. You can see them going into Angmar Court right now. They notified all the people who live on this little court area and telling them they're going to close down the court, make sure that they get out so that they can be safe and get distance from all of this, all of the detonation they have to do, and going through the bomb making materials that they found, which they also found in his work locker at the rail yard. As you heard, this was a planned out attack on the VTA and all of his coworkers, and that he targeted specifically some of his coworkers. Now, they say that they will be here for the rest of the day. It's unclear if they're going to be doing this tomorrow as well. This investigation is very much ongoing. I'll send it back to you for now.
All right. Thank you very much, Sarah. Now, as for the gunman's ex-wife, she's coming.